Success, success, and success once again. What's up, 23% Nation? This is your man, Coach D. Today, I want to welcome you to the Success Saturday video series, where basically we talk about exactly how to be successful while on the 23% Challenge diet, also known as the gut diet. Now, guys, with this video, I do have two objectives. Number one, I want to offer you Coach D's tip. Why? Because I want you to be successful while on the 23% Challenge diet. And objective number two is to solicit your help to help me save 1 million animals. Now, for this video, Coach D's tip is this: find an accountability partner. Once again, find an accountability partner. Now, in order for us to find an accountability partner, I want to address 4 questions. Number one, what does accountability mean? Number two, what kind of accountability partner should I pursue? Number three, what should I look for? And number four, what are the guidelines? So, without any further ado, let's go ahead and dive very deeply into each of these questions. Question number one. What does accountability mean? Well, guys, here we go. Accountability means having both the ability and the willingness to give an honest account of your thoughts, feelings, and behavior to someone else. Question number two. What type of accountability partner should I pursue? Well, guys, your accountability partner basically needs to have these attributes. Number one. A person who is ahead of you, meaning they're doing what you want to do, but in the distant future. Number two, a person with your best interests at heart. So you probably want to find someone who is reliable and dependable, and ultimately someone that you trust and someone that trusts you. Number three, you can also find someone who is your peer, meaning someone who's on your same level. But please, please, please make sure that whoever you pick, not only do they need to be as dedicated as you are, but they also need to be equally motivated. That's right, guys. Now, question number three is what to look for, or what should I look for in an accountability partner? Well, here we go. You need to find someone who is non-judgmental. You need to find someone who understands relapse is a part of the process. You also need to find someone who feels at peace with you, okay? And also you need to find someone who can be your coach and your cheerleader at the same time. Very, very important. Question number four is, what are the guidelines of our relationship? So let's go ahead and dive very quickly into that. Set norms with one another. In other words, make sure that you know what they're doing and they know what you are doing. Next, give feedback more often than you receive it. Very important. Next, push gently, not hard, not abruptly, but gently, meaning encourage the other person kindly. Also, practice good communication skills. In other words, be willing to talk through your feelings. Don't leave it up to body language, and definitely do not expect the other person to read your mind. Also, be consistent and respectful. Very important. Also, own your mistakes. That's right. So if you do something that you're not supposed to do, don't lie about it. Instead, confront it. And also, honor appointment times. So if you guys plan to meet face-to-face or even have a telephone call, then make sure that you are on time. If you can't be on time, then please communicate that too. Now, let's talk about Coach D's amazing goal, which is basically to save 1 million animals. 23% Nation, a few months ago, or maybe even over a year ago, I came across an amazing website. It's called vegancalculator.com. And according to them, eating a 100% plant-based diet for only 7 days saves 7 animals, believe it or not. So now the question is, what types of animals are we talking about, Coach D? Well, basically, guys, there are 2 different types. Number one are the types of animals that we eat for food, meaning the cows, the pigs, the chickens, and the fish. And the second type of animal that I'm looking to save are the types of animals whose natural homes, their natural habitats, are being destroyed because of the standard American diet. So I'm talking about the animals that live in the forests, the animals that live in the jungles, the animals that live on the islands, and of course, the animals that live and swim in our oceans. Very important. So here's how it breaks down. In order for us to save 1 million animals, I need the help of 145,000 people. That's right, 23% Nation. It's time for you to get on board. So please help out Coach D. Well, guys, believe it or not, that's all that I have for you today. Always remember, let's eat well, feel well, think well, do well, be well. This is your man, Coach D. I'm signing out. Always remember to take care, God bless, and never, ever forget that Coach D loves you.